Ciao friends! I already introduced lookup value in a previous video. Now I want to go deeper and analyze performance of lookup value. To do that, let's start taking a look at the data model. We have the usual Contoso model with sales, a date. All sales are stored in US dollars, and I want to be able to dynamically convert them in different currencies. Let's say we want euro. That's why we have the daily exchange rate, which provides the exchange rate day by day in various currencies. I can leverage lookup value to extract the exchange rate of one specific day. And that's exactly what I did with a calculated column in sales that computes the daily exchange rate to euro. I use lookup value, so I first save the current date, and then I use lookup value to get the current rate, where the currency code is euro and the date is the current date. You see, I'm using the expanded table in order to place a filter on the currency code, knowing that this filter will go to the daily exchange rate table. This version works just fine using lookup value, but you need to take into account that lookup value is actually converted using a simpler calculator. This code is completely equivalent to this version of the code, which is longer and does not use lookup value. Let's see what it does. It takes the current date and then it uses calculator. It retrieves the selected value of the daily exchange rate, providing a default value of zero. And it does a filter over all no blank row currency code and another filter over all no blank row exchange over the date, applying the filter on the currency code and on the date. Finally, when lookup value is translated into calculate, it always adds a remove filter on the table. All these details are important. The reason is when the engine translates lookup value into calculate, it uses all no blank row and remove filters in order to avoid circular dependencies in case you create multiple columns with lookup value in the same table. Besides, it is also important to have selected value with the default value here. This is important because the set of filters needs to find only one row. And if it does not find one row, then it returns zero. Why is this important? Because performance-wise, the presence of selected value means that the engine needs to check row by row that there is actually only one value for the daily exchange rate. Let's see that with a more complex query that uses a very similar technique. I have already prepared the query in DAX Studio. What I'm doing here is again use lookup value. This measure is computing the sales amount in euro, so it first summarizes sales by date in order to go at the correct granularity, and then for each day, it retrieves the exchange rate where the date is equal to the same date and the currency code is equal to euro by using lookup value. What if it does not find any exchange rate? Well, in that case, this calculate computes the average exchange rate to euro over all time. So if an exchange rate is not found, then it will use the average over all time as a default value. I can run this query, and as you are going to see, it takes a while. It is scanning 12 million rows, and it executes in around 1.7 seconds. No, 2.2 seconds, actually. There are several details which are important here. First of all, the execution time is very high, and if you look at the number of storage engine queries that get generated, is 932. So it runs a lot of queries in order to return the result. Why is that? Well, if you look at all these queries, they are all needed in order to guarantee that there is actually only one value for the exchange rate in that specific date to euro. The engine needs to do that because we are using the default value of lookup value. Now, if you are sure that your model either contains one row or no rows at all, so you will never find more than one row for the exchange rate in a given date, then a better way of authoring the same code is not to use the default value of lookup value that requires checking for the unicity of the value, but instead leverage the coalesce function. This code is the same as before, but you see I'm not using the third argument of lookup value. Instead, I'm putting it inside coalesce. If I run this query, it will not take 2.2 seconds. It is much faster. It runs in 35 milliseconds, and you see that I no longer have all those storage engine queries. The reason is I have no need to guarantee that there is only one value and exactly one value. In case there are multiple values, this code will break. But if you can guarantee that, you can obtain much better performance avoiding the third argument of, not the third, but the default argument of lookup value, and instead leverage the coalesce function. There is more about lookup value that is worth investigating. A lot of times people use lookup value as a replacement for a relationship. Relationships are always much, much faster than lookup value, and I want to demonstrate you that. Let's go back to the model for a second. I have already a relationship between sales and customer. That relationship is in place. And what I want to compute is the average age of my customers at the time where they purchase from me. A way of doing it is to use lookup value. I can do an average X over sales, and then I use lookup value to retrieve the birth date of the customer where the customer key is identical to the sales customer key. This code is suboptimal, but I'm using lookup value in order to mimic a relationship, which is already in place, but I'm not using it in this code. And then I compute the difference in year between the order date and the customer birth date. If I run this query, you will see that it's not extremely slow, but it takes slightly less than 1 second. And there are other issues here. Look at this row. It is materializing 1.4 million rows. Why that? Well, because I'm using lookup value inside an iteration over sales. And lookup value is translated into calculate. Therefore, context transition is happening, and context transition requires the materialization of large amount of data if it is happening during an iteration over the sales table. I can obtain the very same result, but instead of relying on lookup value, I can just use the relationship. This version of the code does an average X over sales, and it uses related instead of lookup value. Related uses the internal relationship. Therefore, it will not be translated into calculate, and it will just go straight to the customer birth date. If I run this query, I obtain the very same result, but instead of taking 800 milliseconds, it now runs in 8 milliseconds. And most important, you see that there is no materialization at all. The engine is able to, with a single storage engine query, to retrieve the result and produce the number that I want. There are many more details which are interesting about lookup value, but they do not fit in a short video. So if you are interested in these topics, come at sqlbi.com, read the full article. There you can download the file, play with it, and learn more about lookup value. Enjoy, DAX!